Hi, I'm Anne-Marie. I'm here for Sligo today, and I'm with Cormac and Dara from Kerbdog. Welcome.
Can we have a clap, please, ladies and gentlemen? Isn't that nice? Isn't that nice?
Welcome to Temple House and welcome to Sligo. How are you doing?
Very well. The gig is over. I don't know. It must be because I'm getting old, but my voice is absolutely, totally flabbergasted.
You need to get some of Verbal McKee's honey. He was handing it out his gig.
What he does, he pours it down his face.
And he threw it at a kid.
The whipping bite were class.
They were class.
They were deadly, weren't they?
How did you find your gig?
It was a little bit kind of like an isolated experience where I was sitting, but it was good fun. You know?
It was great.
It's nice to play with our old friends again. I never see these guys, himself and Colin. They live in Dublin. I'm still in the sticks in Kilkenny, so it's a random affair that we hook up. So,
Are you going to hook up more?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
What is the plan?
The plan is just to hook up a bit more.
You see, we can't reveal that because, you know, it would affect the NASDAQ. It would affect, you know, all sorts of, you know.
Currencies would go to the floor.
There'll be currency issues and default issues and all that kind of stuff. We don't want to cause any more problems in the country, as you can understand.
And how do you find the festival in general? Did you get a chance to walk around the Temple House Festival? And what do you think?
I thought it was, I think it's brilliant. It's a micro festival, and I think, you know, I think that's what they should be called. And it's a lot, all these kind of festivals that pop up around the country, I think, are really, 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 really good. And it was nice. You know, there was all sorts of stuff happening here that I didn't realise was here. I went to see a guy, Clive Barnes is his name, and he's a virtuoso. He makes us all look very silly as musicians. And he's playing in some place wilds down there through the...
through the
woods.
And there was people hanging out in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah.
I was expecting John Peel to, like, just, you know, reappear and say, oh, that was Clive Barnes. That was Clive Barnes on the stage. Oh, now we're handing back to her. But no, I have to say, in all honesty, I think this is, it's really wonderful to see a kind of like an independent festival that is not kind of run by an overarching, you know, corporate entity. And I don't think that's what's happening. By the way, I love Bavaria beer. Did I say that already? No?
And have you played much in Sligo before? And do you like the Sligo crowd?
Yes, I would say. We did. We played in a place called McGarrigle's in Sligo.
How
a
long
few
ago?
Years.
I can't remember that gig.
It's a good few years ago. It was part of this thing called
Sligo Life.
It actually wasn't. He's telling lies. It was called it was called the Roller Coaster Tour. It was sponsored by some other beer company. But it was great. And we played with Bell X1 and remember Relish.
You know,
there's lots of bands named after condiments, salt and pepper. There's also any other bands named after condiments. Anyone? The Jam.
Jam and Spoon.
Of course. Yeah. Marmalade, a 70s band. You probably don't know about them, but anyway, yeah.
And Salt and Pepper.
Yeah, we did Salt and Pepper. We got anybody got any more quickly? No. Okay, no. So yes, we have, and we've enjoyed Sligo. And as I said from the stage that I have lineage from Sligo.
Yes. Enniscrone,
yeah. My two uncles, Uncle Georgie Battle, Uncle Tommy Battle. Yeah. Are from Enniscrone, and I spent some of my formative years down in Enniscrone, turning me into this fabulous person that I am.
Yes. And you have a great fan base. Everyone I met today wanted to see you guys, and they're really excited. And you recently had a tribute album dedicated in your honour. How does that feel?
It's bonkers.
It's absolutely completely bonkers for these random guys in the UK and this label to actually put in an effort. And we're just getting on with our lives, and this album pops up, and it's quite bizarre. And it's a huge compliment.
Yeah.
And it's kind of a vindication of our playing a million toilets in the UK forever, and not really actually getting anything out, whatever. But for a label and a bunch of bands to kind of compliment us, it is a huge compliment, isn't it?
Yeah, it's right, because, like, you know, I've got a few tribute albums at home, one for Neil Young, one for Bruce Springsteen, blah blah blah,
and then there's the Kerbdog, it was obviously gonna happen
but you know, it was a bit, you know, in a way it was a bit mad and slightly embarrassing as well, because I thought, hang on a second, you know, we're not Nirvana, we're not Bruce Springsteen. We're not. And thank you very much. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. By the way, that's a clap machine. We're just looking into a blue screen. There's nothing happening.
And is there going to be any new material ever?
Oh, absolutely. A double album. We're thinking about a double concept album next.
Yeah, concept.
Yeah. It's going to be lots of concepts.
Why are you giving me the mic?
I don't know, because when I don't... Because when I don't know what to say, I hand the mic over to you. Hope you know what to do.
Okay, there's going to be a live unplugged album. There's going to be a brand new album. It's going to be great.
Okay. On a serious note, there's lots and lots of bands here playing, lots of new Irish bands, and they would all love to have the success that Kerbdog have.
Would they?
And did. What advice do you have for them?
Proceed with caution.
Yeah, although, you know, I would say enjoy it while you can, because more often than not, with most bands, it's a fleeting experience of having fun and being successful and being adored. That comes and goes quite quickly. For most bands, it's very short time. You know what, so do it and enjoy it.
The first night we ever...
And then get a job in the civil service.
After we got signed, we went to this kind of Irma Awards or something. It was some party. And I was chatting to Paul Brady. I randomly ended up sitting beside him. He was at our table. We were at his table. And I said, so what advice have you got? And he said, the chances of making it are slim and none. Just enjoy it. Enjoy every single minute. And it's true.
And
the odds are, if you're a young band and you get signed, you're better off putting your entire advance on an outsider at the Grand National. You've got more chance.
But on a positive note, I would say write loads of good songs and something like that. Don't waste all your time like we did.
And when you're spending £200 a day on rehearsal studios, practice. Don't listen to Depeche Mode outside their window or whatever. Exactly. Just practice.
Yeah. Stop drinking tea, lads. Get on with it.
That's great advice. Thanks for talking to us, Cormac and Dara. Great gig earlier. Thanks so much.
Thank you. No problem.